So we've released the trailer, and people have been positive mostly. Somewhat,
Indeed.
there was that one negative comment on Steam, but usually we're rather positive, and I'd like to thank you for the support. It seems like we're getting, we should be passing green light at some point. We should be getting green lit, but
Hopefully.
I, indeed. Oh yeah, this is Nestor, my artist, or. Yes.
Yes. Hey,
Well,
guys.
I don't own him, but he we work together.
Yes.
So I should address some of the non-obvious, some of the confusions. So first of all, we put the game on green light when it's not finished. Not even that close to finished, because I see it. I see this game at the moment as a kind of development sandbox where I can put things in and then I can play with them until they stop being glitchy in a way. These mushrooms, they don't fit too well into this part of the desert maybe, but they'll be in certain parts and then you.
Yeah, it's just basically just to show guys, people, what we're gonna do, some of the features,
This
some of
area
the.
is somewhat what it will be like. We've got this rock with the hawk and then the starting village. I'm fairly confident that those will be the actual starting area of the game. But don't be confused that and don't think that this is all there's going to be, because there's oh, oops, there's going to be a lot more. There's many more areas planned, and it may look a bit unfinished and crude at the moment because this is still just a lot of testing, and making the actual levels is not the primary thing that we're working on right now. We're working on enemies and bosses and all kinds of things.
Yeah, we're just making sure, we were trying to make sure that all the mechanics work, all the stuff really works, and then after that, then we start working on the design. But we
Indeed.
really just wanna get the mechanics done,
Yes.
semi-finalized.
Like this shooting ant, for example, this honeypot ant, just was one of the earliest things we did, and then
Well, you should tell them what they do. They actually they throw the honey and they slow you down if they hit you. So,
yeah.
I mean, if there's hordes of ants, for example,
That sticks to me.
they're gonna slow you down and then you're gonna get the horde and you die pretty much.
Yeah, I better eat and then otherwise they would kill me eventually. Normally you can only take 2 hits, but the honey doesn't count as a full hit.
Yeah, they're basically like supporting the ants. They slow you down. The ants are other species.
There's no the other ants aren't here at the moment, but they'll be, I suppose, once you cover it in honey you'll surely be attracting all the ants.
Oh yeah.
And these are actually a real type of ant, just in case you were wondering. Oh great, now I died. Well, that means I have to restart and disable the hut. There we go. I spawned in this statue. So I don't want to spoil too many of the different enemies that we have, so just wanted to. Well, that's one of the issues, because obviously we'd want to show. We could show in the trailer a bunch of combat and such, but
That's till later, I guess we could say.
yeah, we'll definitely do more trailers. And then, but yeah, we should try to limit it to the starting area enemies.
I mean,
So
really, yeah, and really, we're gonna start showing more as people actually are interested, right? I mean, right now it's barely the start, and we want people
underway
to actually
samples
know about the
indicate
game and whatnot.
runaway
So,
students.
as we go, as we see that people are really interested, we're gonna. We see that you're interested, so obviously we're gonna put more stuff out there for you guys to actually know.
Oh yeah, I can't wait to work with the community in ways.
Yeah.
I'm gonna upload this series I made of me working on the game, the video.
The programming side, yeah.
So if you're interested in watching me program for hours, then you should definitely subscribe. Anyways, more of the things that were to talk about, and let's see. There were some comments that said that the game looked like it was just a bunch of assets.
And
We're definitely using assets. I think this rock, for example, and then the parts of the village are assets. But then this bird, for example, Nesta made this bird, and the ants and the sombrero and the mouse and the hawk. Basically, basically
all the characters, all the enemies and whatnot. All those things were made by me, but there's some props in here that were made by, they were on the Unity Asset Store, just in case you guys are wondering. But it's minimal stuff. Oh yeah, the hawk.
That'll happen. Oh no.
As you see, since we're still testing, you know.
Oh god, that better not happen.
Things go wrong.
Game crash. Sometimes when I restart, it crashes. Anyone know why Unity games sometimes crash when you restart? I have no idea. I'd like to know.
Yeah. Unity bugs sometimes. I mean, there's all these things we're gonna have to fix.
So much work, but not to worry.
Not to worry. We could do it.
There's a lot of work to do, yes. Oh yeah, the sword, remember? From the trailer? Oh yes. You can throw the bombs.
Yeah, there's obviously gonna be a lot of items. But, I mean, like we said on the Greenlight trailer, it really depends on what the people want, you know? We would like to, like we said, get the fans involved. So, I mean, if we get ideas, good ideas, we'll definitely put them in the game. We'll try to put them in the game. That's the better phrase to use. But yeah, we're definitely going to take into consideration what you guys have to say.
Yeah, let us know. Maybe you've got some amazing ideas of things that we can put in. Maybe something you'd like to see. Some desert animal.
Yeah.
Just so many possibilities. I have a whole bunch of things that I want to do even in later areas. Who knows if the game will be successful enough so that we can make it large enough.
Yeah.
We're definitely
there's a lot of room for growth. That's what I've been telling Florian. I mean, all depends on you guys, really.
Yeah. Oh well, another thing is that me and Nesta, we have different ideas about things. For example, the grass and the environment. I think that there should be, I like the desert from the trailer, for example. Nesta doesn't like it too much. He likes it better when there's more grass around and such, especially
more noise, I guess you could say, more noise on the actual terrain.
Yeah, more
versus really, to me it feels really dull when it's really open, but I mean each person has their own opinion, right?
Yeah. Tell us what you think. You like a lot of grass, or do you like a clear terrain that doesn't
open space, yeah.
That doesn't spawn grass as you go closer, because obviously if there's grass it'll have to be optimized and then it'll go away when it's further away, so that's one of the drawbacks of having grass like that.
Also, one thing I wanted to mention too, what do you guys want? More obstacles, or you guys want more battles? As far as more puzzle, or more, I guess you guys want more action based.
Oh, I'm sure they want all the action.
Yeah, well, depends on people, right? The people that are interested in this game.
Indeed. Yeah, there've been a few nice comments.
Right.
Yeah, so the game is not finished and the gameplay is not finished, but what you've seen, this is actual gameplay. And that hawk just picked up that ant and ate it. And I died. Of course I constantly die. Will it crash this time when I restart? No, okay, good.
Put yourself on god mode.
Do we still have that button? I don't remember. Was it 9?
I don't remember, to be honest. Just don't die.
There's some weird fast forward button. Like, what was that? 8? It was 8. Yeah. Some debug mode fast forward button. Everything moves really fast. Yep, these are the things. And I can teleport in debug mode. I can just move the camera and then teleport.
Yeah. Solver testing.
Yeah. It's be impossible to test without these features.
Right.
Oh, and there's a gravestone where I died on that mushroom. Amazing.
So another question. People are asking, why did we put the game on green light so early?
Oh yeah, that's right.
What do you have to say about that?
Well, there's a bunch of games that are on Steam in the upcoming tab, and they're set to be coming out in 2017, so I thought, why not put it on green light so that maybe it'll take a while to green light anyways, and then if not, then we'll be able to go into early access, and if it does take a while, then...
And not only that, but I mean, like I mentioned before, a lot of people also say, oh, you know, you want the community to get involved, right? Well, if we put this like when it's almost done, there's not a lot of space to do that, right? To actually integrate stuff that people actually want, because we almost have it done, right? So if we start right now, we have a lot of space to actually put stuff in, right?
Oh yeah.
That's another major thing why we chose to put it this early. So we could actually do things that people will want in the game versus later on in the later stages. It's kind of hard to do that because we're almost done.
Indeed. And we can also do bug testing in a way by having early access, and then people can tell us about things that we'll never figure out.
Yeah, there's just not enough time if it's only between me and Florian. So if we get the people involved and actually test the game, I mean, that's a really good way to actually get a polished game.
Indeed.
Yeah.
And the forums on Reddit, I mean the subreddit of Unity, there were some interesting comments on there. It seems that people are familiar with Unity there, and then they gave me some tips, so that's cool.
I mean one thing you guys gotta understand is that Florian was used to Flash games, right, Florian? Like, you, this is your first Unity game, or 3D game at that. So yeah. Obviously there's a lot of learning to go, you know? We need to do a lot of learn. Well, Florian has a lot of learning to do as far as the programming side goes. And, well, yeah, it's going to take a little while, but we're going to get it done for sure.
Oh, God, that's a bug right there. I wonder where the missile went. Oh, shit. Random. Oh, hey, there's a mole. Oh, yeah, check this out, these animations and everything. The mole's going to be in the starting area as well, so I guess that's not too much of a spoiler.
Yeah.
Look at him wiggling around. And there's that new animation that you did, Nestor. Let's see if we can... Ah, not see it yet, I guess. He did the regular attack animation. Come on, do the bite. No?
The colliders, they need some work to do, but...
Oh, there we go. Some. It's not too off. The animation might need a little bit more of a...
Tweaking.
A little more of a longer range, so it fits with the collider. Otherwise, it probably wouldn't reach you too much. But yeah, that's things that happen. Game development in action.
Yep.
There was that whole deal with No Man's Sky and the developer apparently being accused of lying to the fans. So we'll try to avoid any kind of dishonesty.
Yeah.
And that's why we show you this unfinished product as well, rather than just trailers that look good as trailers would. See that bird, that mole being too dumb to attack the bird, the bird being too dumb to fly away.
Unfinished. Yes. See the development as we go.
Oh look, there is that missile I shot at the bird earlier. It just blew up.
Yeah.
This is definitely We're looking the most professional ever right now.
Ah, the beauty of being indie.
All right, so what else did we say?
How seeds and weapons work.
Oh yeah.
About that.
You saw me earlier. I was throwing seeds at the honeypot ant, and then it died. Now I'm throwing seeds at my fellow mice, and I should be able to kill them too. I think it takes 3 hits. I already hit that one twice. Look how I can have these seeds in my tail, and then I can release the button for seed, and then it'll throw it. And it seems I missed, but it still did that in a way, so that's cool. There we go. There is a dead mouse and a glitchy ragdoll. And I can recollect the seed, and the seed is a currency as well as a health item and a means of attacking, yeah, as you saw. So that's one of the features, and then the other feature is the weapons. You can have one of the weapons equipped. Right now I have the pinata. I can throw the pinata, enemies will attack it, and I press the button again, and it blows up.
Yeah.
I can collect more pinatas. I can throw, I think I can carry 3 at a time, so here's more of them. I could even throw the pinata in front of the hawk, and he would grab it, and then he might take a little damage, but not die, because he's a boss, obviously.
Yeah.
The hawk's fairly finished, oh my god.
Oops.
It doesn't crash as often inside Unity as out as in this build, so I'll definitely have to check what's up with that. So yeah. Those are the features that we have, and there'll be more weapons, many more weapons. And some of them will be rare to find, and some of them will be gained for doing quests with NPCs, and then you can wear hats and accessories, and I don't know if they'll give you a bonus or if you learn new moves or whatever, but there'll be a lot of content in this game for sure.
Yeah. And what would you tell people as far as what's the point of this game? Like, what do you do?
Oh yeah, I keep forgetting about that, don't I?
Yeah. That's something we should.
People always ask me, what's the goal of the game? Well, it is a sandbox game where you fight bosses, and you do quests, and you collect seeds.
And as far as like the villages go, I mean, like, you know how we said the point is actually to make the towns thrive, to actually survive, these towns to survive. That's the point. We want the towns to the mice not to go extinct, you know what I mean?
Extinct.
That's the point of basically what you do here. You have to save the town.
Yeah, there'll be several NPCs.
Towns.
One of them will have some kind of quest where you have to fetch X seeds and then bring the seeds to upgrade the town.
Yeah.
There'll probably be one where you have to rescue the mice that are afraid to come to the village because there's too many enemies, and then all kinds of things.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, there's some mini games, some fishing.
There's some fishing. There's some sharks we need to push out of the ocean.
Oh yeah. Oh look, he's colliding with the walls, but not too much damage taken. Yeah, he ran into the village. Oop, and then he dived. Oh, wow. Looks like he face planted then.
A lot of bugs.
I worked on that hawk for so long, and it's just flying around, but I haven't worked on it lately, so some of the code I did on something else might have bugged in, so who knows. Where did he even go?
Probably stuck up there somewhere.
I hear the wings.
Oh, it's actually right there, actually.
Oh, yeah, there he is, glitching about. Oh, boy. Oh, there's the moles that are... They've dug up the crops. They're throwing bombs at you.
Yeah.
The the boss mole.
You're gonna have to push him out so the town can have their crops back.
Yeah, don't want no moles stealing the crops. Do mice and mole get along? Who knows? Not in this game. Yeah, die.
Oh yeah, one comment someone said actually. They said, are they gonna be able to change the skin on the mouse?
Oh yeah.
What do you think about that?
That's the question. Mouse customization. Do we want maybe a fat mouse? Maybe as an albino mouse?
They want different hairstyles.
Oh,
fur,
God.
I should say fur.
I suppose it should be relatively simple to make different furs, but then again, it's already a different texture when you inch it, so I suppose it'll come down to making a bunch of different.
Different, yeah.
I suppose it's possible to make a few limited choices of skin, but who knows if that's a priority. We'll see.
I mean, if people are asking, I guess we could do something.
Yeah. Feel free to comment and subscribe. Yeah. Alright, let's have a look at some more of the comments that were made. I'm gonna Alt F4 and... Yeah, great. There, I had to show some on the side at the close of tabs in the browser. Alright, here we go. Let's see who we hang out here. Oh, yes, Bob the Skeleton. Alright. Oh yeah, there was not... Some people didn't have enough description. Apparently it's a Jerboa, this mouse type. There's also a mouse type that's called a hopping mouse, which looks similar to the one we have, but it doesn't have long ears. Only Jerboa apparently have long ears, so I guess this is what we have. The game's not ideally named.
isn't our mouse a kangaroo mouse?
Yeah, somewhat. I mean, it's... I guess it's not any specific type of mouse that exists, but rather a mixture of several species of rodent.
Are you recording this right now?
Yeah.
You probably shouldn't.
You don't think I should be responding to these comments?
You should, but... anal? Or what does it say on the top over there?
Huh?
On the... Which part? The top... No. On your Windows.
Oh, never mind that. I cut that out.
Okay. Just in case.
What, my weird pony? I don't worry about that.
Yeah, they're gonna be like, people being nosy.
Alright, let's see what else we have. Add some NPCs and dialogues. That was also later added to the description.
Yep.
And then there was that guy who said a bunch of the complaints that we brought up in the previous part of the video. Looks really amateur. The environment is just a bunch of store-bought assets cobbled together.
About the lighting, we're gonna fix all that. I mean, that's the least of our problems right now. That's the polishing stage. We shouldn't worry so much about that right now.
I'm not worried about the lighting in general, because looking at the game and then the way you play in the game is so different. I think that
one thing is actually looking at it through a video, and another thing is actually playing it. You know, it looks kind of it looks different actually.
Indeed, and not just you also perceive it differently because of all the things that you're required to do, and you don't compare the game to other games while you're playing it. You only compare the graphics inside the game with other graphics inside the same game, so you can easily get used to a slightly less attractive game. So even if we don't figure out how to fix the lighting, it'll still be fairly fine, I'm sure. Because the gameplay is obviously the important part. We want all the fun and the exploration to be unaffected by the graphics that we're going to be able to make.
Yeah.
Not, And the graphics will look fine for sure.
Yeah, the graphics we're gonna work on. We shouldn't worry about that too much. But as far as the gameplay goes, I mean, we're gonna make sure that's good.
Indeed, I think more important than gameplay. Yeah. All right, let's see here. Someone says the mouse has been well designed. We saw the picture. I just had to look and see what this was. I was surprised by the voice in the video. Oh yeah, that guy. But I thought it would be sarcastic individual or something like a teen. However, I still like the mouse. Okay, I don't know if this is a... I don't know if he's roasting me right there, or am I sounding like a teen, or is he? Did he expect a teen and not get a teen?
I think he expected a teen.
Why would he? Well, I suppose that makes sense.
But I guess because of the picture, the mouse. I don't know, to be honest.
Oh yeah, you didn't like the picture. Hey, new stuff. Let's check out the new comments live. Oh boy. Oh, it's you. Damn, Nestor.
Yeah, commenting back.
Cute, but so poor. Yeah, good comments. All right, let us leave us comments, but we can't respond to comments here, so if you want to talk to us, then you should use the discussion tab or whatever, just so you know, because we can respond to that and other people can respond. All right, well, someone would like to play this game, and it's nice that people were commenting. Thanks for Edmund to posting it on Twitter, and let us know what you think of the behind the scenes footage and everything.
Yeah.
Subscribe for more. Goodbye.
Goodbye.